to get comfortable with that. But we're going to move on to the next topic, which is dilutions. So, with solutions, which is what we're talking about in chapter 9, when you go to buy different solutions commercially, things like that, they're often provided as a very concentrate in a very concentrated form. Okay, anytime we use HCl, like in the lab, we've used hydrochloric acid a couple times, or any of the solutions for that matter. Most of those solutions you guys use in lab have been diluted from a stock solution that our department purchased. That's way more concentrated and strong. Okay, and sometimes therefore more corrosive or more toxic. So we dilute them down to what we call a working solution so that we can use them in this kind of a safer form. Or sometimes if we're talking about like in hospitals, if you ordered a medication that was an IV type of medication, and to deliver that to a patient, you might need to dilute it to the concentration the patient needs depending on their body size. But if you're looking at this slide, what we start off with is a stock solution is one that is, keyword here, more concentrated than we really need. So what we have to do is we have to dilute the solution to the concentration we want. We call this the working solution. The working solution contains the concentration we want. The question then becomes, well, how much solvent do we need to add to the stock solution to get our working solution concentration? Okay. To do that, we have this handy little equation here. Looks a whole lot like Boyle's law with different variables. So the equation for dilutions, if we end up doing a note card, this would definitely be an equation to add to your note card. Again, you're probably realizing the reason exam 3 is maybe one of the tougher exams is because you have so many dadgum equations. So the dilution equation says M1V1 equals M2V2. And over here, you're told what M and V stand for. M is a molar concentration, V is volume. So if we're trying to answer this question right here, question, how much solvent do we add to our stock solution to dilute it to our working solution? What we're looking for is V1. Okay, and that's explained in this phrase right here. If I know the stock concentration, which is M1, and then I know what volume and concentration I need for my working solution, which is V2 and M2, then I can find the volume of the stock solution that I need to dilute. Okay, V1. All right, so we're going to work some dilution problems. You may not always be solving for V1. You could really honestly be solving for any of the variables in this equation, M1, M2, V2 as well. So here's two dilution problems. The first one says I have 75 milliliters of 3.5 molar glucose. I dilute it to 450 milliliters. What is the new concentration? So I encourage you again, work this ahead of me, work it with me, get some paper and pencil out. Don't just watch me work it. The first thing I'm going to do is go through and label these numbers with their units. Identify what is M1, V1, M2, V, what do I have and what am I looking for? So it says I have 3.5 molar glucose and 75 milliliters, and that's before the dilution. So this has to be V1, milliliters is units of volume. This has to be M1. This is the initial concentration in molarity. I dilute it to a new volume. So this is V2, the new volume. And we're looking for the new concentration, which is M2. So here we're solving for M2. So I'm going to rearrange the equation first. If we have M1, V1 equals M2, V2. Divide both sides of the equation by V2. And it cancels out. So we'll just erase it on this side. Okay, and that's our new equation. Now we can plug everything in. It's okay to do this equation with units of milliliters and molarity. You don't have to convert the volumes, the liters, or anything like that. You can plug everything as is. Plug everything in as is. So let's just plug in M1 V1, 3.5 molar times 75 ml, and it doesn't matter if I wrote volume or molarity first here, as long as I have both in the numerator. I'm going to divide it by V2, which is 450 milliliters, and that's going to give me M2. So now we just do 3.5 times 75 divided by 450, and we get 0.583. And what's our units? Milliliters cancel out. It should be units of concentration, which is molarity. Units of concentration for this equation is molarity. Okay, so that's our answer for the first dilution problem. Let's work another one. It says I can buy 1 molar sodium hydroxide, NaOH. I need 750 milliliters of 0.32 molar NaOH. How do I prepare this? Okay, so let's go through again and label what variables do we have in our equation. Well, it says I can buy 1 molar. So this is the first concentration that it gives us. So this is M1. And if you notice, it's the way more concentrated concentration. That sounds redundant. But that's M1. It says I need 750 milliliters. So this is the volume of the new concentration. So this is the new volume. So this is actually V2 here, because 0.32 molar is M2. This is the diluted concentration, which is M2. So we have M1, V2, and M2, which must mean we need to know V1. How do I prepare this? Well, we need to know what volume of our stock solution we need to dilute. So let's arrange the equation. M1, V1 equals M2, V2. There's our equation. We're going to divide both sides by M1. So divide both sides by M1. That box I drew makes this look kind of confusing. But M1 cancels out on this side. So rewrite your equation. V1 equals M2 V2 over M1. Now we just plug everything in. So I'm going to come up here. V1 equals, plug in M2, 0.32 molar times V2, 750 milliliters. Divide that by M1, which is 1 molar. So 0.32 times 750 equals 240. What are my units? Well, it's a volume here. And in my problem, I have units of milliliters. So my answer, I'm going to have those same units. So that is V1. So the question is, though, how do I prepare this? So the way we would answer that would kind of be in sentence format. You would take 240 milliliters of your stock 1 molar NaOH solution, and then we would dilute it to 750 milliliters. And dilute with water to 750 milliliters. So that actually answers the question of how you would prepare it. Okay, so that is it for dilutions. And I'm going to pause the video here. And then the next video we will pick up with electrolytes, which is the next topic in our chapter.